Well, Jacob, welcome to Sandful TV. How have you approached this pre-season?
With a lot of optimism, to be honest, Zach. You know, when you lose some superstars like we had in our team in Youngie and Maury and even Jesse to a certain extent, and Cam Craig, who'd been here for 17 years, you know, the enthusiasm of a younger list has got everyone up and about. Obviously, we had a big change in our fitness staff over the break as well, and they've come in with a renewed enthusiasm for the group and all that sort of stuff. So there's a lot of optimism. It's very exciting from our point of view.
Have you identified what areas you need for improvement? I guess obviously it was disappointing to slip back from the grand final to outside the top five last year.
Yeah, it was disappointing. You know, you can't help the fact of the amount of injuries that we had to key players throughout the whole year. We always felt like our team was good enough, and we showed patches through the year when we beat the Adelaide Crows here, I think with 19 enlisted AFL blokes. And unfortunately, you know, the cookie just didn't crumble for us last year, and that happens with football. But, you know, we think we've got the game style. We think we've got the players and the recruits that come in that play the way that we want to play here at North Adelaide. We've tinkered with a few things. We didn't have to reinvent the wheel because we think what we do here is very good in regards to our football. And we just needed to make sure that we went out and recruited some of the players that were going to fit the North Adelaide way, and we've done that.
Touched on the youngsters that you're looking forward to coming through, and we'll speak about them in depth in a little bit. But to lose that experience of Cam Craig, as you say, Aaron Young, Andrew Moore, even Jesse White to an extent as well, it's pretty significant.
Oh, it definitely is significant, but, you know, we still got great leaders in Harrison Wigg, Alex Spina, who do a great job, Keenan Ramsey, Mitch Harvey. So there's a lot of old experienced heads there. So the exciting part for me as coach is to see some of the development of Carl Finlay, Dawson Hilder, and a few of these other guys to come through. Harrison Mager, who've played, you know, 2 or 3, 4 years of league football now. It's their time to step up and take hold of this football club and lead it in the right way.
With Young and Moore in particular no longer here, could we expect to see some new faces in the midfield, perhaps?
Yeah, absolutely. Like, you know, Harry Elbro should probably go in there a little bit more after completing majority of the preseason after a little bit of an interrupted year. We've recruited really well. There's Ewan McKinlay, Luke Fellows, and Lukey Lawrence have come in from Melbourne or from Victoria, I should say, and from New South Wales. And, you know, they're a couple of midfielders who are strong over the ball, who are tough in the contest, and have got really good speed and spread. And, you know, after losing those two boys, you know, they both probably didn't have the best turn of speed, which is they can probably agree to. Youngie was very good in the phone box. We really made a focus of going out and getting some guys who've got some real good speed and grunt and power out of stoppage. And, you know, we feel like we've done that. And you know, we've got Sam Mays and a couple of the older boys who can still go in there and do what they need to do. So from my point of view, we looked at a need that we needed, and we went and got it, and we're really happy.
There's a couple of North Adelaide juniors that you're welcoming back as well, where Tarek Newchurch and obviously Blaine O'Loughlin, and then even Akeem LeBoyce comes back too. And you speak about that need for speed, which you really did lack last year. Those three do address that.
Yeah, Tariq's been outstanding so far. He's come off the Crows list with a little bit of a chip on his shoulder. Obviously not playing AFL football, and that's what he wants to do. And, you know, he hasn't missed a beat over the preseason, and he brings a lot of that speed and energy that we probably lacked a little bit forward of the ball last year. Same with Blaine O'Loughlin. He went away and played the year with the Crows in their SNFL team and did an outstanding job. The guys developed him really nicely down there. And he's come back with a new, back to his old environment, but it's feeling really fresh and new for him, and he's been outstanding so far. You know, Kimmy LeBoyce had 12 months off of football just to get his body right. He's had a little baby, so he's getting all his off-field stuff right as well. So he's learning and adjusting how to become a dad, and he's doing a great job there. And, you know, we're really lucky. This is going to be Nigel Lockyer's full pre-season after he busted his ankle last year. So he's flying around on the track, and he's been one that's been really impressive. So, you know, forward of the ball, we're going to have lots of speed. Up on our wings, we're going to have lots of speed. So we're really looking forward to what that's going to bring for us here at Prospect.
We see Tariq as high up on a wing. He's obviously spent predominantly forward with the Crows.
Yeah, Tariq will do bits and pieces. He'll play a bit of forward. We've trained him a little bit as an inside mid as well because he's got really good speed and burst out of stoppage. So, you know, we'll give our guys an opportunity to play where we think they're going to flourish in our game style and our game plan. And that's going to be, you know, a lot of run and carry and the ability to take the game on. And, you know, that's what those guys do. So we want to make sure that we put them in positions where, you know, they can play to their strengths and the strength of our team.
Needed to replace Cameron Cade. Craig, do you feel you've done that with Cody Ruck from the Western Bulldogs?
I'd like to think so, but you can never replace a Cam Craig, you know that. Zach, he's an outstanding individual. I would have liked to see him go on for one more year, but, you know, Cam's got other priorities in life now, which is what happens at our level in regards to wanting to have a family and business interests and all that sort of stuff. So from our point of view, we just lose an outstanding individual from our football club. Cody Rark has come in. He's been exceptional. You know, the guys who come in from AFL level just really show the standard of the way they train at AFL level, and Cody's brought that here to our group, and we probably haven't had a guy like Cody in our back line for a few years who can really come off and mark the ball. He uses the ball exceptionally well, and you know, I'm really looking forward to seeing what Cody can do this year. He's been an outstanding pickup for us. We're very lucky to have him.
Speak of outstanding individuals, Mitch Clisby's one of those. Obviously a bit of a shuffle with the coaching appointments, and he's now the talent manager slash under 18 coach. How will that assist in terms of, I guess, bridging that gap from the graduating 18s up into the senior group?
Oh, it's huge, you know, and a lot of credit's got to go to our former coach, Craig Brooks, who they've just basically done a swap, and Brooks is going to be coaching our reserves now, and he'd done an outstanding job for, you know, 6-7 years with our guys down there, and it was a pretty seamless transition for Cliz to go down there and do that. You know, he understands the way we want to play, the way we want to go about our football, and I think with all the whole program changing across the SANFL, it's just the right move for us. Cliz wants to be in football, he wants to progress his career, and this is what he needs to do for his own development, and we've obviously got a great relationship, and we talk every day, So thrilled to have him there, but then obviously thrilled to have Brooksy back up with us in the senior program. He brings a wealth of knowledge. I think he's been at the club for nearly 20 years in all various types of roles, and we're very lucky to have him back up on the senior program.
Of those graduating under 18s, there's some familiar surnames here at North Adelaide in Harvey and Tasker to speak of. Tell us a little bit about Luke and Tom and what your expectations are.
Well, Luke unfortunately had a really interrupted year. I think he played under 18s as a 17-year-old, and then he had the syndesmosis injury, which put him out for basically majority of the season and just couldn't get himself going last year. He's fit and firing, having a really strong preseason. He understands the way we want to play. You know, he loves training with his big brother, so he's already beating him in all the runs, which isn't that hard. No, he's been great, so I'm really looking forward to seeing what he's doing. The sky's the limit for him, whether he plays league football or not, who knows. I don't put any expectation on our young under 18 kids coming up. And then Tommy Tasker's a young kid who's he's going head-to-head with Kumi and the boys at centre bounce and around the stoppages, and he's been outstanding. I can't understand why he's not in the State 18s program. He's been brilliant for us up on the track. You know, he's a young kid who grows, and he wants to get better. And you know, there's no reason why he couldn't potentially put himself up to play some either reserves or league football this year. He's been outstanding for us.
Who are some of the other youngsters that have impressed you on the track over summer?
Yeah, Hugh Wisman's just gone from strength to strength. He's improved his running, his strength around stoppage, his bodywork around stoppage. He's in here on a Tuesday and a Thursday doing extra work with Sam Mays as his role as head of development. He's been outstanding for us, along with Jed Dignan, a couple of young guys who went through the program last year in the under-18s, and he's really stepped up, and, you know, he wants to play league football from day one. But, you know, I've been thrilled with the attitude of some of the senior players that have come back, like led by the captain. He's just been outstanding in the way he's gone about his professionalism, his leadership on field. He's been outstanding, along with Harrison Wigg and all the other guys. So I've been really impressed with, you know, there was a lot of change in regards to our playing group, but then in our fitness staff and even coaching staff. You know, we had Jimmy leave and go take the Werribee job, which is, you know, which is kudos to him and his development. But then, you know, you bring in someone like Darren Pfeiffer, who's coached in his own right for a couple of years over in New South Wales, and he's starting to step up his own coaching. He wants to be his own senior coach, and he chose our program over a lot of clubs that were chasing him, and you know, he's been outstanding for our group so far. So there's been a lot of change. The players have embraced it. There's a renewed freshness around the club in regards to our playing group and our coaches and the way we're going about it. And, you know, if I was a North Adelaide supporter, I'd be really excited for what's going to come this year.
Speaking of North Adelaide supporters getting excited, we're here at the lovely deck here at Prospect Oval, and it's going to be a picture come Good Friday, isn't it? Round one against Central District here at home. Better way to kick off the season?
Oh, absolutely. It's a great rivalry that we've got out there with Centrals. Obviously, I'm a past player from out there, so it's always got a little bit of spice as well. And I love the Doggies, and I love my time that I had out there. But when they head here, Prospect on that first Friday, you know, we're really looking forward to it. They've recruited really well. You know, they had a great year. They're going to want to back up what they did after last year, and you know, after the last game where they beat us out here by a couple of points, you know, I think we owe them one, and we're going to be ready to go.
It's been a wonderful innovation with the fixture this year to have the Sample W games at the same venue and the same clubs competing too, so that'll be special on the day.
Oh, absolutely. You know, it's been a great initiative, not just for the AFL, but obviously the SANFL having the girls to come in and play and compete for premiership points. So, you know, we invest a lot of time and energy into our program. Chrissy Steen done a great job for, you know, 4 or 5 years as she led the program, and Jason's come in and he's been fresh for the girls, and, you know, they're running and they're training really hard. They're doing all the right things. So, you know, we're really fortunate that we invest a lot of time and money into that program, and, you know, we want to make sure our girls are the most successful group in South Australia, especially in the SANFLW.
And with that Good Friday game, it sparks a run of 4 of your first 5 here at Menzies Crescent. So you could really get off to a fly.
Yeah, well, we did that, started that last year as well, and it didn't do good for us. So now we're looking forward to it. We've got new goalposts here. We've got brand new cricket pitches just been done up. So the oval's in really good shape. So we're really looking forward to getting here and just playing some really good football. And, you know, the pavilion and everything that's happened here at the club in the last 12 months has been really positive. So we just need to make sure that it's positive on field.
Serge, thank you very much for helping us preview the 2024 Host Plus Sample League season for the North Adelaide Footy Club. Wishing you all the best.
No worries, Zach. Thanks for having me. Appreciate it. You know that.